of 1962 was when Kennedy faced off with Premier Khrushchev of the Soviet Union. See, back in 59, Cuba had a revolutionary war that made them a tiny communist country very close to the U.S. shore. That same year, the U.S. made a deal with Turkey's leaders to put U.S. nukes in Turkey to fire at the Soviets if needed. Flash forward to October 1962 again. Soviet nukes are found in Cuba, like ours in Turkey, right near them. The U.S. Army told JFK this was a good occasion to get rid of Cuba's government with a big U.S. invasion. But Kennedy said no, because those nukes were awfully frightening. If we strike Cuba, Russia might think attacking us would be the right thing. It could lead to nuclear war, and of all outcomes, that's the worst. Kennedy said before invading Cuba, let's try something else first. So one night on TV, he announced the plan he'd made. He'd stop Soviet shipments to Cuba with a naval blockade. But Khrushchev of the Soviets said this was risking war. You can't just stop our boats, he said, the blockade will be ignored. When the U.S. got this message, the night of October 23, defense went up to DEFCON 2, the highest alert in history. This meant the U.S. was just one step from launching nuclear weapons. And as the blockade began stopping boats, no one knew what would happen. Then a Soviet agent named Fomin in the States said, let's just try a simple trade before this escalates. Fomin said if the U.S. could promise to leave Cuba alone, maybe the Soviets would promise to take the defensive missiles home. But Khrushchev had a better deal to make a missile recall work. He said the U.S. should leave Cuba be and take their nukes out of Turkey. So Kennedy agreed to never invade Cuba, and he also secretly agreed to take the nukes out of Turkish land. That part was kept a secret, so Kennedy could still look tough. But the fact was that both leaders thought things had gone quite far enough. Kennedy died in 63, Khrushchev lost power in 64, and that's the closest the world has ever been yet to a nuclear war.